In this video, I show you how I built this portable battery sled for the Starlink Mini for ultimate portability. Welcome back, everyone, and welcome to some random mountaintop in the south of Patagonia. As we continue our overland journey through South America, traveling through Bolivia, Argentina, and Chile, the indispensability of Starlink has become increasingly clear, especially as cellular coverage diminishes in these rural areas. Our flat mount rooftop Starlink has been performing flawlessly, and in recent months, many expedition vehicles we encounter are equipped with it, several even using the flat mount 3D printed dish socket I designed. We also meet many heavily laden cyclists making the journey south, and when we camp together, of course, we're happy to share our Starlink with them as we sit around the campfire. And this motivated me to hurry up with a project I've had on the back burner for many months, the cheapest, smallest, lightest battery pack for the Starlink Mini. I call it the Star Sled Go. It's like a little bobsled for your batteries. You can just slide her on in and power up your dish. I designed it to use cheap, readily available 18650 batteries that can be easily recharged from any number of sources. And because the cells are removable, you can carry as many spares as you like to scale as much runtime as you need. Another reason for the removable cells is so that you can take them out and carry them separately, which allows it to be carried on any commercial flight in your carry-on luggage. So let's go inside. I'll show you how I built mine, and you should too. Okay, just a quick thing before we get into it. I don't often ask for thumbs up or nag you guys to subscribe, but if you enjoy this project and want to see more like it, hit that thumbs up button down below so that YouTube suggests it to other people that might be interested, and subscribe to see future projects like this. So, I spent a lot of time refining the design to make it very easy to 3D print and assemble, with features like embossed cell labels, wire channels, and designed supports, making these parts 11% easier to print. In fact, I printed so many revisions while perfecting the design that I nearly ran out of filament, and I needed to ask our supporting channel members to print more prototypes and test fit with their Starlink Minis. And then that snowballed, and we ended up printing many, many dozens of these, and we ordered all the parts to assemble so that we could send a Star Sled kit to any channel member that wanted one as a belated Christmas gift. So a big thank you to our supporting channel members that were able to help out with that massive undertaking. You know who you are, and I appreciate you. Anyway, back to the point. While I designed this thing to be nearly as minimal as possible, we're not skimping on safety. It uses a 6-cell, actively balanced battery management system to make sure the cells stay balanced and are not over-discharged if you forget about it and leave it powered on. This is a big advantage over the drill battery adapters that I see people using, because most brands of cordless drill batteries delegate the low voltage cutoff to the tool and not internally in the battery, and thus you risk damaging your battery by over-discharging it. But before we get too deep into the woods on how I built this, I feel I need to clarify what this is and what it isn't. If you just need to power your Starlink Mini while car camping, you probably don't need this, because you can just power it directly from a 12-volt cigarette lighter in your car. And if you're setting up a tent city, you'll probably be bringing along an EcoFlow or a Blue Eddy battery bank anyway, and you can just plug it into that. There's lots of great options to power the Starlink Mini if you're near your car or can easily haul a heavy battery. There's also great options for ruggedized battery cases like the Starbat Mini that I reviewed last year. That will power the dish for 24 hours or even longer with the optional fold-out solar panels. But at over 25 pounds, that's a bit much to carry very far, especially for through hikers and long-distance cyclists. My design goals on this first revision was to be as small and minimal as possible, easily assembled with a couple of simple 3D printed parts, a cheap BMS, and readily available and inexpensive batteries. If you have a 3D printer, this whole thing can be built for as little as $3.50 in parts. $11.50 if you need to buy the batteries. I didn't want to increase the overall volume of the Starlink Mini with a big dingus hanging off the back. I wanted to keep it slim so it could slip in and out of a backpack's pocket. In fact, you can even use it while it's still inside the backpack. Just reach in, flip the switch, and point your bag at the sky. No messing around with USB battery banks and adapter cables. And I wanted it to be easy to swap out batteries and recharge those batteries. And certainly not build the chargers into the sled. That weight can be carried around separately if needed. You can use these simple USB chargers that charge each cell individually, or you can leave them all in the sled and plug it in with a wall wart like this one. Or you can even use a solar panel like this. More on that later. And there's nothing stopping you from charging at higher rates with a big charge brick like this one, or a purpose-built lithium charger like this. So let's get into the build. First things first, go ahead and put on a pot of coffee. Next, you're going to need the 3D printed parts. And again, I've freely shared everything under a Creative Commons non-commercial license on Cults3D, Thingiverse, and by popular demand, MakerWorld, for those of you who still have your Bamboo Lab printer.
Bruh.
Just search for Everlander's Star Sled Go. And if you do print it, I'd appreciate it if you upload a photo and heart and boost the design so that I know you liked it. If you're somehow the last person on Earth who doesn't know somebody with a 3D printer, you can easily send the files to JLB PCB or PCBWay and get them professionally printed for about 10 bucks. Whatever you do, don't get scalped by the license-evading vultures on Etsy. These parts can be printed for about $2 in filament. Anyway, you're going to need one front housing and one back lid. I've designed the lid with embossed battery polarity markings that can be printed right into the lid if you have filament swap capabilities. This makes it very clear which way the batteries are to be installed, as the markings are visible through the slots in the battery tray once assembled. Speaking of battery trays, you'll need two of these 3-cell SMD battery trays. These are 78 cents each on AliExpress. You'll also need an active balancing BMS. Again, $1.05 on AliExpress. And a 10-cent switch and a 50-cent voltmeter and some other odds and ends. I'll have the links for everything you need in the description, as well as the assembly instructions. I should mention that this video is very much a case of do as I say, not as I do. In case you're new around here, we're currently driving around the world in our self-built overland truck, and I'm literally in a van down by the river in the south of Chile. So because of that, I've built mine using the parts and materials that I have along with me. That's why you'll see this one is slightly different than the instructions show, and in several cases, you'll see hands that aren't mine because I've needed to rely on our channel members to send me video clips of the ideal parts being used. But as long as you get the parts I've linked in the assembly instructions, yours will turn out just as good as the dozens of others we've sent to our channel members. Okay, next is the LED voltmeter, and it's installed in this paper-thin section of the front housing using UV cure resin. This mounts it really nice and solid and helps transmit the light through the face of the housing, as seen in this example photo. This is a really handy glue to have in your arsenal because you can move stuff around and reposition it until you're happy, and then hit it with a little UV pen and lock it in place in a matter of seconds. For an extra good, thorough cure, you can take it out in the sunlight, and that will really harden it up nicely. Next, we'll prepare the battery trays. You can cut 5 lengths of 18 gauge wire and connect the trays in series as shown. This will sum all of your 4 volt batteries up to 24 volts. Next, we'll run the 3 conductors of a ribbon cable down through the bottom and through the provided recess for the battery balance leads. These should pop out like this near the markings for B1, B3, and B5. Then slip the BMS board into its slot and connect all 5 balance leads from the battery trays to the corresponding pads on the battery management PCB. It's not as complicated as it looks. Just connect B1 to B1, B2 to B2, all the way to B5, B5. Next, we install the connector to feed the power to the Starlink Mini. Now in the plans, the 3D model, I've specified a threaded barrel connector that will thread right into the housing and form a nice, firm structural connection. I don't have one of these, so I've scavenged my male plug from this cable, needed to carve it open, and then solder on my own leads. Then I drilled out the hole and encased the whole backside in the UV cure resin. Then we do the same for this scavenged 5.5mm charge port, which I snagged from this high-power chinesium charge controller. Next, I'll wire up this 7.5 amp fuse, and again, I'm using what I have with me, but these ATO fuses can sometimes be a bit tricky to solder because they sometimes are made from a funny alloy and it ends up melting the plastic case before you can get it soldered. So for that reason, I suggest a glass fuse, as the instructions specify. You could try and shoehorn a fuse holder like this one in there, but I think that would be pretty tight once you got everything else stuffed in there, and there's really no reason you should be blowing fuses. It's really just there to keep the keyboard commandos quiet. So once you got your fuse all soldered up as shown in the wiring diagram, we can move on to the power switch. Again, I've salvaged mine from a dead inverter. That can be all soldered up as shown in the diagram and then snapped into place. On the home stretch now, we just need to solder B plus from the BMS to B plus on the battery tray and B negative from the battery tray to B negative on the BMS circuit board. Your coffee should be ready now, so grab a cup and marvel in your rat's nest. Now you can test fit the back cover and install the batteries following the indicators visible in the battery tray, and then flip on the power switch. And if everything was wired correctly, you should see about 24 volts on your LED voltmeter. If the display powered up correctly, chances are you have 24 volts on the center pin of the output plug. Once you've confirmed that, you're 100% safe to slide her on home into the back of the Starlink Mini and power on your dish while on the go. Now you might be wondering where you're supposed to find these fancy batteries and if they're expensive. I chose 18650 cells because they're ubiquitous. They're used in everything from laptops to flashlights, camera gear, power tools, scooters and e-bikes to Teslas. They all use 18650s, and because they're so common, there are plenty of places to get recycled, used, or new old stock batteries for dirt cheap, like 25 cents a piece dirt cheap. But you can also get very high quality cells for 80 cents a piece. These double-wide medical-grade Sonata cells are sold in a 10-pack for $8. Our members have been testing these with great results. Over 5,000 milliamp hours of capacity still remaining. A fantastic deal for new old-stock batteries. And there's lots of other options out there for recycling battery packs where you can peel them open and harvest the 18650s. Just get a pair of thick leather gloves and yank the cells apart and test them with a discharge tester. But if you're not in the mood to harvest cells, there are plenty of listings on Facebook Marketplace where people have already done the dirty work for you, and you can just pick them up locally, matched and tested, ready to go. Now, admittedly, if you're using random harvested cells, there's a chance that one of them could be weaker than the others. But that's the beauty of the Star Sled using these spring contact trays, because if any one cell is weak or misbehaving or all out fails, the BMS will automatically shut down, and it's as simple as popping in another one. If you want the highest quality, premium option, because you want to take them on a plane, for example, and you don't mind paying the price, be sure you're getting real, not fake, high quality Samsung or LG cells. Don't be fooled by inflated capacity claims of nefarious sellers on Amazon. For example, these 9,900 milliamp hour cells actually tested only 1200 milliamp hours. In fact, anything claiming to be much over 3500 milliamp hours is dubious, especially if the price is too good to be true. Again, I'll put links to all of these battery options I've mentioned down in the doobly-doo. Another option for high quality cells is your local vape shop, and that's where I got these. You can be reasonably assured of decent quality batteries because they use them to power a heater element in what amounts to a direct short. So they need very high quality cells to be able to accomplish that. All right, enough about batteries. This unit's basically buttoned up. As you can see, I've sanded it really nicely and given it a few coats of white paint because YouTube need to keep up appearances. Lastly, I'm going to pull the back cover and use hot glue and some UV cure resin to lock down any of the wires that want to rattle and the fuse, lock in the power switch, anything that's going to vibrate, and just give it a nice solid feel. And lastly, we can install the back cover permanently with 9 M3 screws and then give it a test in the real world. Since we know that the Starlink Mini uses about 24 watts once it's online, we can use some second grade math to calculate that these 3000 milliamp hour cells have 11 watt hours each, or 66 watt hours combined, and thus should last about 2.75 hours in a perfect world. Realistically, I'm getting two and a half, but if you use those 80 cent Boston Sonata cells I mentioned earlier, you'd get closer to 5 hours. And if you're just using it sparingly while on a group hiking trip, half an hour or an hour per day, that would be more than enough. Power it up, post your Instagrams, check in with work, update your maps, email your mom, tell her I said hi. So I've been carrying around this 50 watt, 24 volt solar panel for a while now. I'd hoped that I could show it extending the runtime of the Star Sled. It's really thin, lightweight, about the right size that it could be strapped to pannier bags on a bike or a hiking pack. I figured it was marketed as 50 watts, so even if it was half or a third of that, it would match the consumption, or at least recharge the Star Sled in a few hours. But alas, that was wishful thinking, because the best I could get out of this in full sun was 8 watts. And worse than that, the open circuit voltage is only about 20 volts, so it's never going to recharge all 6 cells in circuit. You'd need to split them up and charge them in 2 batches. But if you had 2 of these, or found a similar lightweight panel, a little bit bigger, that truly makes 30 or 50 watts at 30 volts open circuit voltage, you could plug that right into the charge port on the Star Sled and use that to recharge the batteries, or keep it going as long as there was sun. So I'm really happy to have this project done, and I'm looking forward to taking it along on some multi-day hikes we have coming up, maybe do a live stream from the top of the Torres del Paine. I think it would be really handy too. As we continue south in the many fjords in southern Chile, we have some multi-day ferries coming up where the truck may not have a clear shot of the sky, so we'll be able to carry this up to an upper deck and get a solid internet connection up there. So, what do you guys think of revision 1? Should I have invented a USB PD boost converter to charge 24-volt batteries via USB-C? Should I have tapped into the data lines on the BMS and broken out each individual cell voltage and the current shunt values to an ESP32-based web server? Should I design a 3D printed accessory for the Star Sled that allows you to flat mount the dish to your truck roof using rubber coated magnets? I did that one already, actually. Should I make another version that uses 16 AA batteries? Should it have loops on it to strap it to your bike or backpack? Let me know down in the comments, and if there's enough interest, maybe I'll make another version. If you're interested in seeing what we've been up to for the last few months, you can check out the videos and the members only playlist. And if you like what you see, maybe hit that join button. Let me know what you thought of this project down in the comments below. What situations would you use such a battery-powered mini Starlink for? A massive thank you to our supporting channel members that make these videos possible, especially our top-tier members Furious George, Cecil Neville, East of Somewhere, Seam, John S., Austin Space, Aaron Isaac, Frank Brantz, and Gary Radon. To everyone else, thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time.